Hey, what's up guys, it's Kaustubh here, and today as per the title we will be taking a look at the Havok OS version 3.7, which is a Android 10 based custom ROM for the OnePlus 3T. And also as per the drill guys, make sure you hit that red subscribe button down below and also turn the notifications on so that you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. So without wasting any further time, let's roll the intro and let's get the video started. So firstly guys, this is the OnePlus 3T which I'm using right now, and it is running on Havok OS version 3.7. We'll just quickly take a look at the ROM info. So by just going into the settings, so here in the settings, about device, Android version. So as you guys can see, we are running on Havok OS. Here we get the logo, then Android version is Android 10. This is a Android 10 based custom ROM. Then the next thing is Havok OS version. It is Havok OS version 3.7. That is the latest version for Havok OS, as well as the security patch level is July 5, 2020. So that's a good thing that we're getting the latest security patch with this build. Baseband version build date, as I told you, it is the latest build. A kernel version is given and build number. So that's about it for the ROM info. Coming to the second thing guys, is the display and the overall ROM customizations. So by default, if we go into the settings here into display, so by default we get all these basic settings like brightness control, night light, dark theme is pre-included. Styles and wallpaper is also something quite common in Android 10 based ROMs, so I will not go into depth. I have covered it in each and every ROM video. So you get a lot of options to customize the default styles, the clock, the ambient clock, and the wallpaper as well. So that's about it for the display customizations, the basic ones that we get. Screen timeout, nothing too fancy out here, like all of them are the basic ones. If we go into the ROM customizations, we get a separate tab here, that is the configuration center for Havok OS, and this includes all the customizations that the ROM has to provide, such as status bar, quick settings, lock screen, ambient display buttons, gestures, notifications, battery saving, then battery screen animations, miscellaneous and about info. So this, if we go into the about info, this is the team which is behind the Havok OS build, so kudos to them for making this excellent ROM, I should say. Next thing going to is the edge lighting in notifications. If we go here guys, here we get the edge lighting functionality, so we can click it, keep it on show always, or as well as we can set the color of the edge lighting and other things as well. So this is a really cool feature that I like, so that's why I am showing you this. So that's about it for the customizations that this ROM provides. There are a hell lot of customizations you can try out if you try out this ROM. Coming to the third thing guys, is the special ROM feature that this ROM has. So a lot of you guys have been asking me about a volt support on all of my ROM videos, so I will just quickly show you that. If I go in mobile network, I have a Airtel SIM card, by the way, I am from India. So we get the volt service here, and you can also see that the volt icon is still visible out there. So volt absolutely works great, like no issues with it. 4G LTE works fine on this ROM. Coming to the next thing guys, is the face unlock. So if we go into security, which is similar to that of Google Pixel face unlock, here as you can see guys, we get face unlock by default. So that's also a nice addition to the ROM, because fingerprint sensor sometimes doesn't work, then face unlock really comes handy. I will just quickly demonstrate that to you. It works really quick, like in a second only it detects my face and gets unlocked. So face unlock is still there. Coming to the next thing guys, is the default launcher and the performance of this ROM. So by default, this ROM comes with this new launcher, I should say, that is the Shady launcher. I was expecting a Trebuchet launcher, but it doesn't have the customizations that Trebuchet launcher has. But nonetheless, you have got all the basic customization, that is home screen, app drawer, grid customization, icon customization, or gesture navigation. But guys, what I would suggest you is that don't use the stock launcher, just go for a Nova launcher. I always do that. Talking about the performance guys, the launcher is really smooth enough, like there are no any hiccups or any stutters, as like I have been using this for about a week now and it works absolutely fine. The app launching speed is really great, and it's really smooth overall, like the performance is nothing to complain about. Coming to the next thing guys, is the camera performance, and surprisingly enough, this ROM comes pre-installed with the OnePlus stock camera app, as you can see here, and it has all the features like video, photo, nightscape, pro mode, time lapse, slow motion, panorama, and a lot. Also, HDR control is something which is not working. I will show you that. Nightscape is present, histogram and horizontal reference line. HDR controls are not working somehow. I don't know, this ROM doesn't support it or what, but it just doesn't work. Also, it comes pre-installed with this stock OnePlus Gallery. So you get both of the stock apps. But as always, guys, I would suggest you to use a Gcam mod. And in this HDR control work, it can go up to HDR enhanced, and you can extract the full potential of this 16 megapixel shooter out there. So as always, I would suggest you Gcam mod, and the camera performance will be really good with this. Coming to the last thing, guys, is the battery life. Battery life has been pretty inconsistent for me, at least. Some days I am getting around 4 to 5 hours of SOD, and some days I am getting hardly around 3.5 hours. So battery life has been inconsistent. Like, I have been using this for about a week right now. You get all the basic normal functions, that is adaptive battery, smart charging, and all that good stuff. So battery wise also, it is there. Like, you can get around 3.5 to 4 hours of SOD, that too on a moderate use. If you game, then the battery is gonna drain easily. So that's about for the battery life. So finally, guys, concluding the video, the Havok OS, as I said, the battery life is a bit inconsistent, but then too it's okay. Like, the ROM is overall pretty stable. If you want it, you can definitely try it out, but still I would suggest you in Android 10, if you have to try, then you can try out Evolution X. Would be my first choice for battery backup and overall stable performance. So that's about it for this video, guys. I hope you guys like this video, and if you like it, then please do hit the like button down below, and also do get subscribed to my channel for more such amazing content. This is your boy Kaustubh here from T2E signing off. You guys have a great day.